Hello, everybody. Welcome to Stan's Garage, your behind-the-scenes look at the IT industry, providing you the necessary insights to maximize your technology investment. We're now in part three of the series I call Everything You Ever Wanted to Know About Managed IT. Hopefully, this will help you in the process of deciding what means of IT support will best benefit your business and if an outsourced managed IT services provider will be the best choice for you. If you missed parts one and two, they're on the channel and get into what managed IT typically includes and some great ways you can implement an MSP's services to support your business. Now, previously I'd done a video about how managed IT may not be the best choice for you. Today, in a somewhat related topic, I'd like to get into some of the pluses and minuses of managed IT services. Not surprisingly, I'm a big believer in the benefits of utilizing an IT managed services provider. As someone who lives and breathes this stuff daily, I find the best way for a business to have a robust and scalable technology infrastructure is to outsource some part of it, if not all, that work to a trusted partner. I could go on ad nauseum about why this is a great idea, but I've got four big reasons why, and I'll list them here now. Number one, you have a 24/7 team dedicated to supporting your IT needs. Now, without being overly repetitive, your businesses need support. Having a partner capable of providing it whenever you need it, that's a pretty major benefit if you ask me. Internal staff goes on vacation. They get sick and they have other commitments that will otherwise render them unavailable. Having an agreement with an MSP alleviates those gaps in coverage. MSPs leverage a number of skilled technical staff members with exposure to numerous technologies. Along with the people, your IT provider should maintain detailed records on all aspects of your technology infrastructure, including your staff, devices, processes, software, and the platforms you use. In the event one of the individuals who typically help you out isn't readily available, one of their colleagues will be at the ready to take care of any issues that may arise. Number two, you'll be working with some real IT experts. As someone who runs an MSP, you're not going to get far unless you really are a master of your craft. You've got to hire and regularly train staff with already a great deal of technical knowledge. Also keep in mind, an MSP gains a lot of expertise by working with a number of clients across many different industries. This sort of expertise is not something a sole engineer or even a small IT team can pick up from a single environment. That same expertise can be leveraged to help your business in multiple ways. You can certainly use this to help you handle your day-to-day IT needs. Where you can really benefit is to utilize that knowledge to help streamline business processes, increase stability, and keep your environment secure. You'll also be gaining the sort of expertise and wisdom to help you as technology and your business needs evolve. Your MSP can certainly help you with new IT projects as your needs dictate. Most importantly, you have a trusted partner who really gets to know you and your business. You gain an ally in helping you achieve greater business efficiency through the use of technology. With the expertise your MSP provides, you really do gain extra advantage in growing your business. Number three, the most cost-effective way to get IT talent. Not only are you getting some of the best possible IT expertise available, you'll be getting it at a far better, more predictable cost than any of the other common ways of receiving IT support. Well, short of doing nothing and scrambling to find someone to fix things when they break, and even then, you've got to factor in the lost productivity. I could go on and on why that's a horrible idea, but hey, people will learn that one way or another. I've done an entire video on MSP pricing, as well as having typical pricing options listed on our website. And I'll get more into a cost analysis, managed IT services versus other options in a later installment in this series. But for what you'll pay for a typical MSP contract, you couldn't staff a single capable help desk tech. Mid and senior level staff are going to run substantially more as well than if you go with an outsourced provider. Let's also factor in that you're not paying taxes, training, and benefits to your outsourced techs while still getting up to the most senior level of staff to deal with the entire range of IT requirements. Number four, hiring an MSP is far more flexible than hiring in-house. Hiring in-house certainly lacks the adaptable nature of outsourced IT. You'll likely have HR and other requirements when hiring internally. You'll also need to consider their fit in your organization and all the soft costs of bringing this individual to your team. Not to mention, finding this person will likely have some costs, both in terms of time on your end and other advertising and recruiting expenses. You also need to consider the ramifications of hiring someone and the labor laws surrounding their employment if things just don't work out. With an MSP, your contract is laid out from the start, so you always know what to expect and the associated costs. If you need additional services or support, those will be scalable to fit your needs. Now, as I've mentioned on several occasions, working with an MSP is not an ideal fit for every organization. Some organizations just aren't a terrific fit for one another in all industries, and managed IT services are certainly no exception. While I'm definitely of the belief almost any business can achieve great benefits working with an outsourced IT company, for many of the reasons I'd previously highlighted, here are three drawbacks that can potentially come up when you work with an MSP. Number one, you don't always have that on-site, hands-on IT support. When you outsource your IT, you do give up having that IT person standing by at your office, ready for whenever an IT issue arises. Yes, that person can have a lot of familiarity with your systems and staff as well. Now, that's not to say your MSP won't have as firm a grasp on your IT needs as an in-house person, but they won't be there until a need arises. This can be a bit of a culture shock initially to staff used to having that instant on-site assistance when they need it. The good news is most problems can be resolved remotely and quickly. And should you require that on-site assistance, your MSP will be there to provide it as quickly as necessary. Besides, who really wants to see their IT staff every day? In my corporate days, they'd stuff us way in the back of the office, far away from you normies. If businesses actually wanted to see their IT people, they sure have a funny way of showing it. But rest assured, you'll still get that in-person assistance from an MSP. It just won't be there every day. Number two, you may need to overhaul some of your equipment. Now, many SMBs bring aboard an MSP to get their technology running smoothly. This often presents a challenge when a prior provider did not work to keep things up to date as well as they could have, or even worse, the company's priorities didn't include updating their technology. To provide the best possible service, your managed IT company is going to need equipment that's up to the task. Your MSP certainly wants to bring everything as current as possible. This is the real win-win both your organization and your technology provider can enjoy. The more efficient equipment is far better maintained going forward, and your staff can do their best work without their technology holding them back. If this isn't something your company is going to value nor able to commit to, hiring an MSP may not be the best choice. You certainly can, but it wouldn't necessarily give you the results you're looking for. Older, outdated equipment will take longer to support and still possibly not yield the results you're hoping for. Meanwhile, you're still dealing with issues that can only ultimately be resolved by upgrading. So in essence, bringing aboard an MSP without being dedicated to having up-to-date equipment and solutions will be a problem for both your company and the provider you hire. And number three, MSPs tend to work best for specific sizes of companies. The ideal client for the fully managed, entirely outsourced IT services MSPs provide range from around starting at 10 staff all the way up to maybe 200. For full transparency, particularly if you're on the smaller side, unless you're really willing to adapt to the standardized way an MSP will implement your best-in-class solutions for your team, it's not necessarily an ideal fit. This is the range we found will typically benefit from the services an MSP provides, but not quite ready for a full-on internal IT team. Now, just because you fall outside this range, don't fret. You could still benefit from managed IT. As I'd mentioned in the prior video, if you're a larger business, you could definitely find ways to leverage an MSP in a co-managed IT arrangement. Or if you're smaller, growing, or just highly tech dependent, working with an MSP can help you manage your business without having to worry about the technology holding you back. Well, so that about sums up what benefits and potential pitfalls you should consider when you're thinking about working with an MSP. Do the benefits seem as though they'll be a positive impact for your business, or do some of the drawbacks seem to speak to you directly? It's fine if you're still on the fence somewhere in between. I'm not sure if this is for me, or let's do this. Where do I sign up? In my next video, I'm going to get into more of the specifics of who are the best fits for managed IT services, and I hope you'll watch. So thanks for watching this one. Please like, comment, and subscribe. I'll catch you on the next one.